Subscribe to Jazzy's Recipes and click on the bell icon for more updates.
Hi everyone, this is Jazla Ismat. Welcome to Jazzy's Recipes. Today I'm going to show you how to make chicken dum biryani, which I'm sharing today is a very delicious recipe and the steps are so easy to follow and the end result is quite rewarding and impressive. Start by cooking the rice. Here I have taken 1 kilo basmati rice. I have washed and soaked the basmati rice for 30 minutes and add enough water, then add 2 bay leaves, star anise, cinnamon stick, cardamom pods, cloves and salt as needed and give a good mix. Cook the rice up to 80%. Once it's done, strain all the water from the cooked rice and keep it aside. If you overcook it, the whole biryani will be mushy. So stand near the rice and keep checking it. It will just take 10 minutes for the rice to get cooked. The second step is to marinate the chicken. I have taken 1.5 kilo chicken and marinate with 4 tablespoons of red chili powder, 3 tablespoons of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, salt as needed, 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, 2 tablespoons of full of curd, juice of 1 lemon. Give a good massage with your hand. Once you massage well, add handful of fried onions, handful of chopped coriander leaves and handful of chopped mint leaves. Now combine everything together and cover and marinate the chicken for as long as you can, but not more than 6 hours. Take a wide heavy based pan, add 2 tablespoons of ghee. Add handful of cashews and fry for 30 seconds. And then add handful of raisins and fry until they puff up. And then transfer into a plate and keep it aside for later use. In the same pan, add 2 tablespoons of oil and then add 2 bay leaves, few cinnamon sticks, star anise, 4 to 5 cloves, 3 to 4 cardamom pods, 1 teaspoon of peppercorns and fry everything for 2 minutes on a medium flame. And then add the marinated chicken and give a good mix. While marinating, I forgot to add cumin powder, so in this stage I am adding 2 teaspoons of cumin powder. You all can add the cumin powder during the marination. And then add few green chilies and 4 to 5 chopped red tomatoes. Cook the chicken for 15 to 20 minutes on a low flame. Chicken and curd will release enough water, so do not add any water and stir once in between. Once the chicken is cooked, switch off the flame. While the final chicken curry will have considerable amount of gravy, it shouldn't be watery. And ensure that the oil has separated from the curry. Biryani is all about the dum. Yes, it's time for dum. Now transfer the cooked 1/3 of chicken to a large heavy bottom pot and spread evenly. Now layer the 1/3 of rice on top of the chicken. Do not press the rice with a spoon. The grains have to be nice and loose. Next, add half of the remaining chicken gravy and then sprinkle some of the coriander leaves, mint leaves and some fried onions on the top of the chicken masala. Then spread half of the remaining rice and then spread the remaining chicken masala. And finally, top the rice, followed by some of the coriander leaves, mint leaves, and fried onions. Mix milk and yellow food coloring in a small bowl and pour the yellow milk around the layered rice. Also, add 2 tablespoons of ghee, 2 tablespoons of rose water. With a kitchen cloth or aluminium foil and seal tightly. Now place a flat griddle or tawa underneath the pan to diffuse the heat. Then turn down to the lowest heat and allow it to cook in its dum for 50 minutes. After 50 minutes, turn off the heat and allow the biryani to rest with the lid for 10 minutes. Do not stir or mix. To serve gently, scoop out the biryani from the bottom of the pan so you will get the layers of rice and meat along with all the wonderful masalas. Just before serving, garnish with some fried onions, some chopped coriander leaves, some mint leaves, fried cashews and raisins. Now the dum biryani is done and ready. I hope this wonderful chicken biryani recipe is loved by all of you and I hope to receive feedbacks after trying out the recipe. Don't forget to share and like Jazzy's recipes. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe for more recipes. Thank you for watching.